يسأل عن حكم الحركات الزائدة في الصلاة، ويقول إنه كثير من الشباب والصبيان يتحركون كثيرا، ويقولون في كلام سمعه أنه إذا تحرك المصلي أكثر من 3 حركات فلا تصح الصلاة. He says, what is the ruling about the extra movements that the people do while praying? He says many youth and young children, they move a lot in the prayer. And he heard that it is said that if you moved, the praying person moved more than 3 movements, then his salah is null and void.
نعم، هذا ذهب بعض أهل العلم وهو مذهب أبي حنيفة والشافعي.
Yes, some of the people of knowledge, like the position of Abu Hanifa and al-Shafi'i, they are of this position.
إلى أنه لا يجوز أن يتحرك أكثر من 3 حركات.
That it is not allowable to move in the prayers more than 3 movements.
وبعضهم ذهب إلى بطلان الصلاة.
And some of them, they are of the position that the salah is null and void.
قال لأنه ينافي الخشوع.
They said because it completely in opposition to خشوع, humility in the prayer.
ومذهب أحمد كذلك النهي عن كثرة الحركة.
And the مذهب of Imam Ahmad also is that it is to the forbiddance of moving a lot in the prayer.
لكن لا يحددونه بثلاث.
But they do not restrict it to 3 movements.
ولكن يقولون ما كثر عرفا.
But they say what customarily it is known that it is a lot of movements.
بحيث الذي يراه لا يدري هل هو يصلي أو لا يصلي
من
كثرة حركته.
The person who is looking at him, he doesn't know if he's praying or not because he's moving so much.
وقد جاء في حديث.
It has come in a hadith.
لو سكن قلب هذا لسكنت جوارحه.
That if the heart of this person was tranquil, then his body parts will be tranquil and at peace.
لكنه حديث ضعيف لا يثبت.
But it is a weak narration that is not established from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ومشهور أنه من كلام سعيد بن المسيب.
And it is what is well known or famous is that it is from the statements of سعيد بن المسيب.
وهو من التابعين.
And he is from the second generation of Muslims, تابعين.
أما الحركة في الصلاة.
As for the movement in the prayer.
فالصحيح والعلم عند الله تبارك وتعالى.
So what is correct and the knowledge is with Allah تبارك وتعالى.
أنها تنقسم إلى 5 أقسام.
That it is categorized into 5 categories.
بحسب الأحكام الخمسة.
According to the 5 legal rulings.
حركة واجبة.
A movement that is a must.
حركة مستحبة.
A movement that is recommended.
حركة مباحة.
A movement that is allowable.
حركة مكروهة.
A movement that is disliked.
وحركة محرمة.
And a movement that is haram.
أما الحركة الواجبة.
As for the obligatory movement.
فلو كان الإنسان يصلي إلى سترة.
So if a person is praying towards a cover, something that is in front of him.
وأراد أحد أن يمر بينه وبين سترته.
And someone wanted to pass between him and his cover.
فيجب عليه أن يمنعه.
So it is a must upon him to prevent him from that.
لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لو يعلم أحدكم ما ينقص من صلاته.
If one of you knows how much his salah will be diminished.
لما ترك أحدا يمر بينه وبين سترته.
Then you wouldn't leave anyone passing between you and your cover.
فهذه حركة واجبة.
So this is a movement that is a must.
وكذا لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كان أحدكم يصلي إلى سترة.
Likewise, the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that if one of you is praying to a cover,
وأراد أحد أن يمر بين يديه,
and someone wanted to pass in front of him,
فليمنعه.
Let him prevent him.
فهذه حركة واجبة.
So this is a movement that is obligatory.
وهناك حركة مستحبة.
There is a movement that is recommended.
كقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من وصل صفا وصله الله.
The one who joins a line, connects a line, Allah connects with him.
فلو كنت تصلي في الصف.
So if you are praying in the line.
وصار فراغ في الصف الذي أمامك.
And there is a space, a blank space in the line that is in front of you.
فلك أن تتحرك حتى تسد هذا الفراغ.
So it is allowable for you to move on to fill up that gap.
أو كان فراغ عن يمينك أو عن يسارك.
Or if there is a gap to your right or to your left.
كذلك تتحرك لتسد هذا الفراغ.
Likewise, you move to fill in the blank space.
لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Because of the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من وصل صفا وصله الله.
The one who connects a line, joins a line, Allah connects with him.
فهذه حركة مستحبة.
This is a movement that is recommended.
وهناك حركة مباحة.
There is a movement that is allowable.
وهي التي تكون لحاجة.
And that is that you do for a need.
وقد ثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
It is established from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
كما في البخاري
as in Bukhari
أنه كان يصلي
that he was praying
أمامة بنت زينب حفيدته
and he would be carrying عليه الصلاة والسلام أمامة the daughter of زينب his grand daughter
فكان إذا أراد أن يركع وضعها في الأرض
so he when he wants to make ركوع عليه الصلاة والسلام he would place her on the floor
فإذا أتم الركعة الأولى وأراد القيام من الركعة الثانية حملها معه مرة
If ثانية. If he finishes the ركعة and he wants to get up for the second ركعة, he will carry her again with him.
وهذا أيضا فيها يعني سعة للنساء this, مع أطفالهن.
This actually gives room for يعني an allowance, a concession for the women with their kids. They can carry.
وكذا كان إنسان يصلي فجاء الذبابة أو نحلة Likewise, على عينيه أو
if
كذا.
If someone was praying and a fly came or a bee came on his eye or in his head.
فلا مانع أن يحك وجهه يحرك يده
There is
للحاجة.
Nothing wrong if he moves his hand or he rubs that place because of a need.
فهذه حركة مباحة.
This is a movement that is allowable.
والنوع الرابع وهي الحركة المكروهة.
The fourth kind and that is the disliked movement.
وهي التي ليس لها سبب.
And that is done. That is the one done without a reason.
مجرد العبث.
Just playing around.
وهذه مكروهة.
And this is disliked.
وإذا كثرت.
And if it is done a lot.
فهنا تكون محرمة.
Here it becomes prohibited.
وتبطل بها الصلاة.
And the صلاة becomes invalid because of it.
ومن هنا قال بعض أهل العلم أنها إذا كان ثلاث حركات فأكثر.
And because of
لأنها
this.
لأنها صارت كثيرة.
Some of the scholars they said if they were three movements and more, this is now it became too much.
يقصدون هذه الحركة التي ليس لها داعي إلا العبث.
They mean that this type of a movement that there is nothing calling for it except just playing around.
وبعضهم جعلها معلقة بالعرف إذا كانت كثيرة عرفا بحيث الذي يراه لا يدري هل هو يصلي أو لا يصلي.
Some of them linked it. Some of the scholars linked it to the custom in a way that if someone looked at this person and he would think that he is not praying according to what is customarily known because of the many movements he would tell that this person actually is not praying.
وقد رأيت صديقا لي.
I have seen a friend of mine.
بعد أن انتهينا من الصلاة.
After we finished praying.
وكنت أنا في الصف المتقدم عليه.
And I was in the line in front of him.
فلما أردت أن أخرج من المسجد.
When I wanted to leave the masjid.
وجدته
from the masjid,
يعبث بأصابعه وينظر.
I found him playing with his fingers, intertwining them, and looking at me.
فجئت ليسلم عليه.
So I came to shake hands with him.
فنزل يده وصار يحرك يده.
So he put his hands down and he started moving his finger for the tashahhud.
فهذا كنت لا أدري هل هو يصلي أو لا.
So I didn't know if he was praying or not.
وغلب على ظني أنه لا يصلي.
And what I most likely thought that he was not praying.
فهذه هي الحركة التي هي عبث.
So this is the movement that is just someone is in vain, يعني playing around. طيب جزاكم الله خيرا شيخ.